The first option I have for you are the hydration packs or hydration bladders. I'm looking at a 3 liters Osprey hydration pack here. I personally find them to be very practical and very useful. This one here fits 3 liters of water, and this is a good amount of water if you are going on a long day hike or an extended backpacking trip for one night, two nights, or even more. The one thing I like about the hydration pack is that you fill it with water, you throw it in your bag, and then you have a tube that's feeding directly to your mouth. You don't have to reach to grab the water bottle. It's very easily accessible and is going to help you ensure that you are staying hydrated and you are drinking a good amount of water while hiking or backpacking. Next, I'm going to move to the smart water bottles. These are very known in the hiking and backpacking community, and the reason is, let me show you. If you are using a Sawyer filter, it can hook directly to the water bottle. And just like this, you can fill your water from a water source and then you can squeeze it and drink directly from this water bottle. I personally take a smart water if I am going on a long backpacking trip and I know that there are reliable water resources throughout the way. So if there is a source, I would fill the water bottle directly from the water source and then I would use the filter to drink directly from this water bottle. This one right here is 33.8 ounces, and there is a smaller version of 20 ounces. Really depends on what you are looking for, but these are a great option if you are just trying to drink water on the go. The next option I want to talk about are the Hydro Flask water bottles. These two right here are similar. They are 32 ounces. They are insulated. There are a lot of advantages about these two water bottles. There are also some inconveniences, and I'm going to talk about both. So these are great if you are going on short hikes or taking a walk around the block. I think that it's great that it has a handle and you can just carry it this way. The other thing that I like about this specific water bottle is the wide mouth. It allows you to drink water easily and to add ice if you want to. These two bottles are insulated. It keeps hot drinks hot and it keeps cold drinks cold. So this water bottle is great if you are going on short hikes or if you are hiking in high temperature weather and you want to have a cold, nice drink by the end of the hike or when you get to the top if you are climbing. This is a great option. We took it on so many short hikes and it works pretty well. Again, you can use this one for cold beverages, water, alcohol, or hot drinks like coffee. But the downside for this water bottle here for me is that it's really heavy. I took it with me when we hiked the trail to Machu Picchu, and I think it was an overkill. It was really heavy. I mean, I was thinking the other day that this can be used as a weapon, to be honest. It's really, really strong and sturdy. So maybe if you get attacked, you can attack back with this water bottle. I don't know why I'm thinking about this scenario, but I am. And that's the 32 ounces Hydro Flask wide mouth. And now we are going to go to another version of a Hydro Flask, and that is the 24 ounces standard mouth. I love this Hydro Flask. This is the one that I lug around the house with me if I want to make sure that I'm drinking enough water. It's also insulated, 24 ounces, keeps hot drinks hot, it keeps cold drinks cold. The only difference between this one and the previous one is that, first of all, the size or the capacity, and then the mouth. So this is more of a standard mouth. It's good for drinking water, but if you are outside in snow and you want to shove some ice in here, it's not going to be the best option for you, but it's still a good option for short hikes, I would say. And moving on to another option here, and that is the Camelback with a jet valve. To be honest, I don't take this one with me on my hiking or backpacking trips, but I think it's a great option if you find the Hydro Flasks to be a little bit heavy. This one is great mainly for biking if you are looking for a quick grab and go, just squirt some water and you are good to go. It is BPA free, it's not insulated, but it can be a good option if you are going on shorter hikes in an area with a more pleasant weather. And that takes us to the last option in the list here, and that is the Nalgene water bottles. The Nalgene water bottles were mainly made to be used in laboratories, but then they started getting popular in the hiking and backpacking community. So the Nalgene water bottle is great. It's 32 ounces, that's almost 1 liter, and it can work for both hot beverages and cold beverages. There are a lot of great things about this water bottle. Again, the wide mouth allows you to drink water easily. I love the fact that the lid is attached to the water bottle. This way you don't drop it on the trail and you don't lose it at all. And the other thing that I like about this water bottle is the fact that I can use it as a photo prop. So these two here are my favorite water bottles. This is mine. It says, a life outside is a life well lived. And then this one says, enjoy the switchback. So whenever we are hiking and we want to take some nice expressive photos, I would use it as a photo prop as well. And I know that a lot of people would use them when they are backpacking. They fill them with the hot water and they would just fit it in the sleeping bag to keep them warm. To be honest, it's not something that I would do unless I am freezing cold, but that's just another thing that you can use this water bottle for. I also use it when I am traveling to refill water in airports and so on, and I think it's a great water bottle. It is also BPA free, and I think most of the Nalgene water bottles are made of low density polyethylene, at least this one that I'm looking at right here. These are the options I had in mind for you guys today. The intent of this video is to give you a general idea, but by the end of the day, it depends on what you are looking for. Thank you guys for watching, and if you found this video to be useful, give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to our channel. And if you haven't followed us on Instagram, make sure you do. We share tips and tricks about hiking, backpacking, and adventure traveling, as well as some behind the scenes from our own adventures. Thank you again for watching. Your trekking pals, Habiba and Alex, and we'll see you soon on a new adventure.